Today, everything you need to know about the perspective grid tool in Adobe Illustrator, brought to you by Satori Graphics. So I'm going to show you how to use a perspective grid in Adobe Illustrator, and also a few tips and tricks along the way. So first and foremost, here is the perspective grid tool in the toolbar. And if you hold down a click, you're first going to open up the perspective grid, but also you're going to see that there's a perspective selection tool below, and both of the shortcuts are given off to the right. Now firstly, I know some of you would have clicked this by accident many times in the past, and maybe you can't figure out how to actually remove it. All you need to do is simply come up to View, Perspective Grid, and then hide the grid, and also the shortcut is presented here. So for me it's Shift Command I, and that will toggle the grid on and off. Now the really important thing that we're going to be utilizing later in the tutorial, the perspective grid widget, which is located here. But for now, I'm just going to quickly show you the different handles on the perspective grid itself. So firstly, the top anchor point here, you can bring this down to change the height perspective of the grid, like so. But then you'd imagine that this one lowers the bottom perspective, but that doesn't. This actually changes the amount of squares that you have on your grid. To change the bottom perspective, you must click this one here. Now the two other handles off to the right and left here, these actually break up the X and the Y axis. And I personally don't really use these ever in my workflow when using a perspective grid. And then these two handles here, these change how far your grid extends off into the distance. And then finally here, you can actually change the perspective itself by sliding left and right. But going back into the perspective grid menu here, there are actually quite a few settings that are a bit off my screen, but you can choose a 1-point perspective grid, a 2-point or a 3-point. And these are actually pre-made grids. So for example, here is the 1-point perspective. And also just a little bit off my screen that you can't see, you can actually save your grid as a preset. So if you're working on a specific design or project, you might want to save the grid that you've made. And this will come in handy too. So how to actually use the grid to make shapes and designs? Like I said before, the widget is up here, and this is really, really handy. You can see there's a blue square highlighted. So this basically means that anything that we design, Illustrator is going to automatically place it into this perspective center here. If we then toggle onto the right-hand side on the orange, designs and text will be placed into this perspective here. And then finally, the green is the upper and the lower ones, which will make sense later as I show you. But also you can actually press here, which now means that any design you make, so for example, I could take a square. If I place a square here, it's just a normal square. Illustrator sets the square to the contour of the perspective grid. However, if you take text and you type in some text, you will notice that it doesn't actually conform to the perspective grid. Now this is because with text like this, you need to take the perspective selection tool, then take your text and place it in like so. You can also do this with shapes as well, and you can actually make designs on a different artboard or different document, then bring them onto your perspective grid using the perspective grid selection tool. Also, another setting that you might want to take into consideration is the snap to grid. Now this is when you're drawing with the pen tool on the perspective grid, Illustrator is going to snap the points and the lines, the vector paths, to the lines on the grid. Now this can be handy for some situations, but other times it could be annoying. So do be aware of this setting here. And also there's actually rulers that you can turn on and off as well. So with everything in mind that we just went over, you can use the perspective grid here to make a kind of cuboid design. So press M for the rectangle tool, and then choose your color or your fill and stroke here. Then go ahead and choose the destination for your shape to go onto the perspective grid. So I'm going to start with the green top here, which is this section of the widget. And then I can zoom in to make sure my shape is precise. And as you can see, it's really that easy to make a shape, 3D shape, in Adobe Illustrator. Still with the rectangle tool selected, if I actually do this, I can then create the second side of my 3D shape. And then finally, let's go on to the orange side. Now I can actually use a shortcut from earlier, which on a Mac is Shift Command I. And I have three shapes, which I can then adjust the color and, you know, gradient or whatever I wish to do. So I can imagine some light coming from here. It would make this side a bit lighter. Top might be dark, but still lighter than this side here. And there, as you can see, it's really that simple to make a perspective shape in a 3D manner using the perspective grid in Adobe Illustrator. Make sure to like and share my content on social media, and also subscribe to my second channel, linked down in the description box below. Have a great day, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.